Hey, brothers and sisters of the Crib, it's me, the Doctor, DrCrib. And today we're playing Call of Cthulhu. Yes, we're gonna conjure Cthulhu himself. At least we hope so. Starting off in chapter 1, Pierce Investigations Agency in Boston. Boston, 1924, Edward Pierce, veteran of the First World War, drowns his memories in liquor and sleeping pills. He is now a private detective who has trouble finding a case able to lift him from his torpor. Pierce must find a new case quickly or risk losing his license. Enter madness, they say. If I am mad, it is mercy. May the gods pity the man whose in callousness can remain sane to the hideous end. Cthulhu, the doctor will see you now.
What a putrid offering.
A bunch of whale carcasses. Yep.
Don't fight. You have been chosen.
I love triggers to him. I have been...
Behold! Everything has already been written. But perhaps you will attempt to change your destiny.
Story of blackmail in a speakeasy. Natural sciences, linguistics, archaeology. Been a while since I jotted down something other than my nightmares.
Thank you.
I'm listening.
Are you Edward Pierce, private investigator contracted by the Wentworth Detective Agency?
That's correct.
Hello, Mr. Pierce. I'm Lucy Sherifield, in charge of investigators over at Wentworth. I'm calling because of a problem with your file. A fire has destroyed some of our documents.
Oh, no.
Is that right?
I'm so very sorry, but I have to collect your personal information yet again.
Occultism, medicine, strength. Validated.
Thank you for this information, Mr. Pierce. Our files will soon be up to date. And on a related matter, may I raise a sensitive question?
What's wrong?
As you know, we wish to closely monitor the progress of our contractors. And it would seem you've been accepting fewer new cases.
Work is scarce.
Mr. Pierce, you know as well as I do, there's never been more investigative work than now.
But are those cases worth it?
They're worth not losing your license. Show yourself worthy of the Wentworth Detective Agency, and we might keep you on the payroll. Mr. Pierce, are you still...
I'm coming!
So it's results, results, results.
Sir, I came here on the advice of a person whom I hold in high esteem, and I must say that I expected anything but a drunkard's lair.
You're free to leave anytime, sir.
Do you know to whom you speak?
Stephen Webster, industrialist and art collector. All of Boston knows you.
Tell me, Mr. Pierce, are you capable of handling a new case, or are you simply a deadbeat inebriate?
If you come to me, it means you're desperate.
Nobody believes me. They take me for an old fool. Sarah, my little girl, she is dead. Even you must know of her. She was Sarah Hawkins.
The painter? Yes. Everyone knows her work.
The police accuse her of killing her family. They all died in a fire. Sarah, her husband, and Simon, my grandson.
I can't do anything for a woman who is already dead.
Find out the truth. They say she was mad, but I know that's a lie. She would never have done such a thing.
But if you have no proof...
I've brought all that I have. Look. I want you to look carefully at this painting. Tell me all the assumptions that come to mind.
What am I supposed to find?
Tell me if this is the work of madness. Or if, on the contrary, you manage to detect some logic. A rationality to follow so that I may understand it.
Is that all you want from me?
Yes, please.
All right. I'll look at your picture. That's all you've got? The painting?
I placed a file on your desk. It contains everything I have on the affair.
A warehouse on Darkwater. Some sketches of the Hawkins family. Rather thin.
look at this painting, shall we?
Its strange beauty isn't enough to hide the feeling of dread it carries.
So, Mr. Pierce, what do you make of these elements?
You must tell me if what the police suggest about the mental state of your daughter is true.
No. Sarah had visions. Everyone knew that. She never would have hurt a fly. She only thought she saw things.
Saw things? What do you mean by that?
I never knew what she meant by that. My daughter was an enigmatic figure, Mr. Pierce. You must find out the truth about her life and death.
Darkwater. Never heard of the place. Where is that?
It's a small, remote island off the coast of Boston. Sarah lived there with her son and her husband.
I suppose you want to ship me off there.
Darkwater holds the secret regarding my daughter, Mr. Pierce. You must uncover it.
And we will.
Her husband was a big deal on the island. But the police are sticking to the accident theory. Though they mentioned Sarah's mental state was fragile. I believe you are right, sir. This case is not as simple as it appears.
I am aware of that. I believe there is more to this case than just an accident.
The sender's label mentions Warehouse 36.
That's right. It came with Sarah's last painting.
And you think your daughter could have been the sender?
That is what you must find out. Go to Darkwater. Find Warehouse 36.
I think I'm beginning to understand.
I'm willing to do anything for my daughter to recover her honor.
Quiet down. I'm on your side. Let's sum things up. An artist dies with her family in a house fire. Your only clue is a sort of promontory painting sent from Darkwater right before her death.
Correct. And the rumors about her supposed folly.
Which you don't totally deny.
Find that warehouse. Find out the truth regarding Sarah Hawkins' death. You'll be handsomely compensated.
All right. I'll take the case. I'll go to Darkwater and look into the death of your daughter.
Thank you, Mr. Pierce. I didn't expect any less coming from a man in your situation.
Something's queer, but it's not like I have a choice.
Ain't that the truth?
Darkwater. I think I've got a book on the North Atlantic. I'll no doubt find some information on this island in there. I used to be an avid reader. The Wentworth Agency doesn't attract top-notch cases. Married woman runs off with her girlfriend. The husband couldn't understand it. Darkwater is off the coast of Boston. But I've never heard of it. According to this, all I have to do is go to the port. I just hope that I can find a boat able to take me to Darkwater.
Chapter 2, Darkwater Port. Call of Cthulhu.
Stay on board. There's guys coming to unload. Welcome to Darkwater Island, Mr. Pierce.
Why, thank you, Captain Fitzroy.
So, what wind brought you?
Does the Hawkins case mean anything to you?
A sad story that we would all prefer to forget. Charles Hawkins may have been a landlubber, but he was a good man.
And his wife, Sarah Hawkins.
A nice young woman, and a great painter. What a tragedy. You know what? Go have a drink at the Stranded Whale. What you need is a good pick-me-up. Mitchell may not be very welcoming, but his bar holds a surprise for you. As for me, you'll find me at the Harbor Master's office. If it's the Hawkins family that brings you here, I have a pile of documents that should interest you.
Understood. I'm going for a look around the docks.
Please move back. Let the police do their work. Hey, Sullivan. Can't you go any faster?
You see how old this thing is. If we force it too much, we'll break everything.
You can't do that.
But it's only a fish.
A fish? You've got no idea. Don't badmouth what you don't know, or you'll pay for it for sure.
Okay, that's enough. Step back and let us do our job.
That's no way to treat an omen.
Oh, yeah? He's gonna get us into trouble. You can't understand. You're not sailors. It's a sign. There's something coming.
The same goes for you, sir. Move along.
They seem to be very agitated about a dead animal.
You're telling me? These fools think that putting the whale back in the water will bring about the end of the world.
They're superstitious.
If only you knew. They only listen to Captain Fitzroy. And not always. And you. What brings you to our island?
I'm looking for this address. Warehouse 36, Darkwater Harbor.
I like you, so I'll be frank with you. Don't go near the place. Don't try to get in.
Why?
Because I told you so. Learn to accept some friendly advice. Now, please, allow me to do my job.
Don't put that beast back in the water, you shysters. You're crazy.
The blood is just beginning to coagulate. It died a short time ago. Killer whales have few predators. And there are no sharks in these waters. What creature could possibly have done this?
Don't put that beast back in the water, you shysters. You're crazy.
They're cops. They can't understand.
Interesting.
What a true sailor's got in his belly. You hear that?
There's nothing for you here either. Beat it.
What did he call us just now?
I said you were a bilge rat.
Okay.
Prohibition is just a joke around here. That suits me fine.
This tended wheel.
Hey, be careful. Let's get him another drink. He's dry.
In my bar, we don't serve troublemakers.
You saw what happened. He's the troublemaker.
Oh, you're a true mainlander. A real princess. You strut around with your la-di-da ways, and then, as soon as the pressure rises, you start squealing. You don't have what it takes to drink my whiskey. You've got to earn it.
I'm here for information, not for a fight.
I prefer it that way. Speak then. I reserve the right to answer or not.
I didn't expect to find alcohol on this island. What's the source of this miracle?
You mean who? Our source of supply wouldn't like me to betray them to the first comer.
I'll tell nobody.
She'd know it anyway. Anything else?
The stranded whale. I guess this bar has been here a long time.
What can I tell you? I'm a nostalgic sort of guy. The name, it reminds us of the golden age of dock water, when our whalers left for long months and came back sweating and stinking of the oil and flesh of the whales they'd been hunting.
It was a tough time, all the same.
Ah, but steeped in glory. We've never known such wealth since then.
What can you tell me about her?
We all knew she was famous on the mainland for her paintings. Never understood why. Then, I don't want to speak ill of the dead.
Her style made her famous. How would you describe it? Torture?
Yeah, well, it wasn't normal. I mean, for a young woman with a child and all that. We saw them in the papers and we said to ourselves, who can paint such things? Is that how she sees the world?
So they made you feel uncomfortable?
You need to see them for yourself. Make up your own mind.
I've got what I need.
Anything else?
What can you tell me about her?
We all knew she was famous on the mainland for her paintings. Never understood why. Then, I don't want to speak ill of the dead.
Her vision, was it so terrible?
The way I see it, the truth is really a question of point of view.
What do you mean by that?
Do you still trust the truth after a bottle of whiskey?
I've got what I need.
Anything else?
Do you know where this place is? Warehouse 36, Darkwater Harbor.
The Hawkins Warehouse. I see, yeah. If I were you, I wouldn't hang around there.
Why not?
First off, there are rumors. Sailors from around here say you can hear noises coming from the warehouse at night. Screams, that sort of thing.
Screams?
And that's not all. There's the fate of its owners and all the superstitions that go with it. But I'll say no more. Anything else?
Captain Fitzroy told me about a little pick-me-up.
Oh, yeah? That must have been before you came looking for a fight in my bar.
Oh, come on. Because of a little tussle.
Drinking it here is a privilege, and I grant the privilege to whoever I want. Anything else?
That'll be all for now. Said, you have no right to treat us. The miraculous catch. Apparently, the most significant event of the last 80 years.
I see.
And the doctor, what did he say?
He laughed.
My God.
You saw
it. I wouldn't laugh.
She will do it again, you know.
Oh,
the girl, Doctor. Cold. She won't stop asking.
Not that again. She will get us into trouble.
I know.
Cold. Ah, there you are, Fitzroy.
I've brought out the Charles Hawkins cargo manifests. They're on the table next to you. But in truth, you're likely to be disappointed. When you're done, come join me on the deck.
These manifests are signed by Charles Hawkins. But that's all I'll get from them. This blackboard hasn't been used in a long while. Fishing equipment. Could do with some rust remover.
The toilet. Unlike Snoopy.
The Scylla. It finished up beached at the entrance to the harbor.
I am a detective, after all.
This man and Fitzroy could be twins. What a macabre souvenir. I wonder what Captain Fitzroy has got to say about this woman, Cat. Broken. This place seems half abandoned.
From here, I see everything that goes on in the harbor. The hard-working lives of my sailors, the fights at the stranded whale. Even the antics of these wharf rats don't escape me.
It's you who lays down the law around here.
Oh, I wouldn't go that far. I'm just the last serving captain on Darkwater. Tell me what I can do to help you.
I'm looking for Warehouse 36. Do you know where it is?
Look, it's right there. The warehouse is opposite the jetty. You can't miss it.
Understood.
You know who the building belongs to, don't you?
It belonged to the Hawkins family.
Precisely. Ship owners from father to son.
I think that somebody here wanted me to search this warehouse. Your manifests have been blacked out. They're totally unreadable.
Yeah, I saw that. I've got no idea who did it or why. I don't remember having countersigned anything special enough for someone to hide it.
And why obliterate the dates as well as the goods stored in the warehouse?
You mean that the dates have some meaning?
I know that Charles Hawkins was descended from a family of shipowners, and the island's fishing industry was hit badly.
Indeed, we specialized in whaling, but no whalers went out to sea after the miraculous catch of 1847.
So where did the Hawkins family get its money?
Well, from what Charles inherited, I presume. Although, these dates on the manifests could indicate that he had contracts of another kind.
With whom, I wonder? The miraculous catch. Is it a local legend?
Not at all. It's an episode from our glorious past. Go read the story of the sailors' return to Darkwater Harbor. It's displayed on a wall of the stranded whale.
I'm just back from the wharves. The dead killer whale is unsettling the sailors.
Ah, yes. Us men of the sea are superstitious folk.
I examined its wounds. I know of no creature able to cause them.
And I took you for a detective.
Believe me when I say that these wounds are significant.
Come, come. You've only just arrived on Darkwater, and already you think like a sailor.
The police took the decision to put the killer whale back into the sea.
You've got to understand them. They didn't know what to do with it.
I think that was a mistake. Who says that whatever caused those wounds is no longer in these waters?
You think we should have kept it?
To look into the real cause of its death, at least. I was looking at your photograph. The one of the man in front of the boat.
Ah, yes, I can see the one you're talking about.
Interesting resemblance. I thought it was you, but with a wooden leg.
And for good reason. That's my father in the photograph.
Your father?
John Fitzroy, captain of the Scylla. His wooden leg is here. You can go and see it if you're interested.
I found a threatening letter signed by a certain cat.
What? I don't mind you visiting my harbor master's office, but I'd prefer if you didn't go through my affairs.
Are you being blackmailed?
Not exactly, no. That shyster wants to make us pay protection money.
With any success?
I wouldn't say that, but she terrifies my men as much as her own.
Can you not do anything to stop her?
Don't you worry about that.
I shall be on my way.
So come back and see me when you've got something new.
Understand?
Damn stupid idiots.
Forget it. Nobody listens to us anyway.
Where do you think you're going?
I thought that the Hawkins case had been closed.
That's true.
So what are you doing on guard duty in front of this warehouse?
Who's asking the questions here? The cop or the tourist?
What more can you say about the death of the Hawkins family?
Not much more than what everyone knows. I wasn't on the case. They were all burnt to death, right? Up at their place.
The whole mansion went up in flames.
Don't get it into your head to go wandering around up there. It's dangerous.
What do you mean by that?
The only one left there is old Silas, and the accident has affected him badly. He can be unpredictable. Especially if a stranger starts poking around the property.
Is he a danger to the public?
No, he's in his own home. Do yourself a favor. Leave him well alone.
You live here?
Why did you do that, huh?
We saw what you did to St. Brendan.
Yeah, we'll teach you to come onto our island and ridicule our protectors.
I've never heard of this saint. Is it a local belief?
But everyone knows St. Brendan, the navigator.
He's the patron saint of whales and whalers.
What happened to the statue?
Go see for yourself. He's at the end of the jetty.
There's you, our beloved statue, and then those two bozos behind us. Wait, now that I think about it, it's got to be them. There's one of them who's always going back and forth to the statue.
Quieter. That's all we need for them to hear us.
What brings you to Darkwater?
The two guys behind you. What are they guarding?
The bootleggers. Scum.
They're protecting their territory. From whom, I wonder?
They really don't have a choice anyway. They're more scared of Cat than an attack by drunken sailors.
If only they would kill each other.
Is it Cat who's shaking down Captain Fitzroy?
Hold on just a minute. We didn't tell you a thing.
Nothing at all.
Is Isn't that a bit early for alcohol?
We got nothing better to do anyway. There's not much work around here.
Fitzroy gives us a few chores every now and again, but since the whaling station shut down, ain't a lot of jobs left around here.
So we drink.
That statue represents your local saint.
What do you mean by local, exactly?
You wouldn't be looking down at us, like all townspeople do.
Saint Brendan. He protected whalers and fishermen like us. Until those assholes defaced him.
Peculiar house.
Yeah, that's where we live, our boat.
It's not because it doesn't float anymore that we're going to abandon it.
I've taken enough of your time.
We'll see you later.
St. Brendan, patron saint of sailors and travelers. Desecrated. I can't even say which language it's written in.
They still have the big homie way over there. We gotta find a way in that warehouse.
Ah, you could tell me. No, if it gets out, I'll have serious problems with you-know-who.
How could you be dumb enough to leave the entrance to the warehouses unguarded?
Keep your voice down. Why not go and shout at the cat while you're at it? I don't want to end up with her little knife under my throat.
It's a stiletto, you idiot. And with that smell on your breath, I don't give you much chance anyway.
It looks like there's a way in under this grate. I could use this.
Oh, okay. Makes sense.
A whale vertebra. The newspaper clipping in the bar is true. This bone is a real fossil. This handle will be perfect for the winch.
You got it.
It should be possible to mount this cogwheel on the winch. A ratchet device. Exactly what I need.
Okay.
Looks like everything is in its place. All that's left is to try to turn this handle. Damn, I broke it.
Damn it. It's fine. We'll always find a way. Nothing we can do then.
Well, well. A little mouse has got lost on our turf. What gave you the crazy idea to come onto my turf?
Your turf? That's news to me.
For a guy who has no idea, you've been doing a fair bit of poking around. My men saw you staking out the Hawkins warehouse.
Is that against the law?
I'm no idiot, Detective. I'll tell you how things work around here. I decide who comes in and who stays out. And anyone who doesn't respect my rules, I punish them.
Is your name Kat?
What of it?
Maybe we can come to an understanding.
Maybe. Or maybe not. Get this joker out of here. He might have a little trouble walking on his own.
Oh. I'm getting careless. I didn't see that coming. If I want to get into this warehouse, I'm going to have to deal with her.
I didn't see it coming, but I don't think it was a good idea to hit her.
Get it. Nobody listens to us anyway.
That's no way to treat an omen.
Another break?
One of those damn sailors came looking for trouble again.
Hey, Mitchell. A drink for our new friend. I owe you. You don't know how to fight, but at least you've got guts.
Yeah. Aching guts.
Huh. I've got them too. But you don't hear me whining like a pooch who's lost its leash. You didn't back down. Something that I respect. So understand by that. If I catch you again, you'll carry a more permanent reminder of our encounter. Tell me, what brings you to Darkwater?
I'm investigating the deaths of the Hawkins family.
It's very nice of you to tell me the truth so openly, but it's also really stupid of you. You really don't seem to know the area. Let me give you a little advice. If you want to survive more than a day in this rat hole, avoid talking about them to the first people you meet.
I need to get into the Hawkins warehouse.
You're out of luck. It's on my turf.
It's precisely for that reason that I've come to see you.
Are you pulling my leg?
Think it over. I've seen what you're capable of. And you didn't miss me.
I accept the compliment. Well, I see you're serious. To be honest, as long as it doesn't interfere with my business, I don't care. But I'll go with you, to make sure you don't stick your nose into things that don't concern you.
Sounds honest to me.
I'm not finished. If I do that for you, if I let you onto our turf to conduct your little affairs, you'll be indebted to me, and I guarantee that I always collect on what I'm owed. Think about it. I help you, you'll owe me a favor in return. Do you accept?
Do I have a choice?
Oh. We always have one, Detective. Follow me.
Nobody questions your authority here. I was given to believe that Fitzroy stood up to you.
That dope tried to save face in front of his sailors. They revere their brave captain as they do their old statues. But sooner or later, all statues get buried in bird shit, and nobody cares.
And the police? They do nothing to stop you?
The local cops? The cops drink like everyone else, sweetheart. They know where their interests lie. Apart from that pig-headed Bradley. I don't know whether to admire his stubbornness or to have pity on him.
Forget it. Nobody listens to us anyway.
That's no way to treat an omen.
Oh, yeah? He's gonna get us into trouble. You can't understand. You're not sailors.
We saw this guy poking around here.
It's fine. He's with me.
Oh. Okay.
That's right.
Be a gentleman and move that for me.
Whatever. For you.
That's how it's done. Do I still need to hold your hand? Or do you think you'll get by on your own now?
Don't overdo it.
Good. In that case, I'll leave you. I've done enough mothering for now.
Ugh, this place stinks. What is the connection between this place and the Sarah Hawkins case? Who has enough money to buy painkillers, but stays in a place like this? It smells as bad as it looks. Can't sleep. I know how that feels. What happened here?
Punch them here.
What is this picture of Charles and Sarah Hawkins doing here? Is this one of Sarah Hawkins' paintings?
Settled in here.
And whoever it is has something to tell me about the Hawkins case.
Is there anyone in there? You! Don't move!
You again. I told you to stay away from this warehouse.
You seem like a competent officer. We should help each other.
You're trying to manipulate me, Mr. Pierce. I hate to be taken for a fool.
All right, Inspector Lestrade. Let me take a more direct approach. Can you explain what this painting is doing here?
This strange portrait. Wait, I know it. It was in the Hawkins mansion when we came to investigate the fire.
So you confirm that it was removed from the crime scene? Interesting. I'd like to go and see the mansion now.
Of course. You want to go back along his trail? I'd like to understand how this painting made it to here.
Come on. My car's parked down the way. Andrews, would you please shut the door? And open your eyes, damn it. This guy went right under your nose.
God damn it. Her again.
This case has nothing to do with you, Baker. Clear the passage, or I'll shut you up for obstruction.
Officer Bradley, you've finally grown a pair. Too bad you're too fat to see them down there.
town.
Why are you?
Come on, keep the smile. You don't want to force me to widen it.
Okay, I get it. Can we go to the mansion now?
I thought I'd straightened you out, mister. I am disappointed, but we'll meet again.
Is it far, this mansion?
Look behind you, at the top of the ridge. You see the building? That's the Hawkins Mansion. Come on, we got some driving to do.
Finally, we're going to get the mansion.
Well, here we are, Hawkins Mansion. The place has been abandoned since the fire. There's only old Winchester in his hut.
Your partner, Andrews, warned me against him.
You managed to get something out of that bum? I'll end up asking you for advice.
He talks too much. He inferred that old Silas was slightly unhinged.
That's not far off the mark, I suppose. But kinda unfair at the same time. You know, Silas Winchester has been working for the Hawkins family as far back as I can remember. Charles was like a son to him. The day of the fire, he lost his whole family. So he's got nowhere to go. And, as you'll see, in a way he's still watching over them. Is there anything else you want to ask me? Or do you want to go up there?
Night falls quickly here, and I want to be able to see when we arrive.
I'll go with you, if only to reassure Silas.
Why not? You can help.
Right. Let's go. I told you. Silas Winchester is still watching over the Hawkins family.
I must say, it's pretty gloomy.
So, Detective, does this place inspire any thoughts?
Why were they buried here?
I was given to believe that it was Charles Hawkins' wish.
Strange idea. I imagine Webster wasn't too pleased.
Mrs. Hawkins' father? It's said that he's devastated.
Let's go to the mansion.
Please give me a minute. I didn't expect to set foot back here after the burial. What kind of deranged individual would defile this sanctuary and steal a burnt painting? I don't see Silas doing such a thing, let alone allowing it. Even that broad baker is above that. Lord, have pity on this poor family.
This entrance is still in use.
Whoa!
Whoa!
You are trying to force the door, you nosy prick!
Easy, sir, all right? Put down the axe.
You know what we do with rubble like you? We gut them! Dump them into the ocean!
Whoa! You're Mr. Winchester. Lower that axe. Let's talk calmly.
I'll show you how we have it out on Darkwater.
You haven't forgiven yourself. You stay here to honor the memory of the deceased.
That's true. I want no more violence. No more tragedy.
It's painful to be the last one left.
You don't know how right you are. Understood. I'm listening.
The police report describes a domestic accident. But Stephen Webster has several reasons to believe that this may not be the case.
Webster is as stubborn as an old mule. And I did tell him that we should let the dead rest in peace.
He wants to restore the reputation of his daughter. I just need to see where the fire started.
No, I can't let you in. The mansion isn't safe.
That's why you barricaded the entrance.
That's right.
And this door?
It's locked. And I make sure it stays that way.
No one lives in the mansion, and you don't take care of it anymore. If you have a good reason to be here, I'm listening.
There's vermin. I keep an eye out.
Vermin?
Yeah, that's it. Vermin.
Right. This is what we're going to do. I go inside, and I promise that I'll hunt vermin. Okay with you?
I'm not sure.
If there's nothing else to fear, you can give me that key.
Right. Take the key and do what you have to do. Go on, then. Just to get rid of you.
Let's see what more I can learn from this mansion.
What now?
Piers, shall we enter?
Now that you finish your fun and games with Silas, we can perhaps inspect the mansion.
You're right. Let's go. Let's take a look inside.
I'm with you.
Follow me. I know the place. Who left this light on?
Well, we're gonna have to leave it here. Oh, rats. Thank you for watching, and part 2 will be coming soon. Bye-bye.